Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Storytime. My name is Miss Katherine, and I am a children's librarian here at the Greenwood Public Library. This is our Jumpstart Storytime for babies and toddlers. It is a developmentally appropriate and enriching program for our littlest ones, and it is most effective when watched with a grown-up or a caregiver. So I hope you guys are able to enjoy this together. Let's get started with our opening song. So for our opening song, we're going to actually do the opening song from our terrific twos program called Gilly, 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 Good Morning. It's got a nice hard G, G, G at the beginning for our little ones to practice that sound if they're talking. So let's get started with it. We're going to pat those legs. Good job. You got it. Gilly, 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 good morning, good morning to you. Gilly, 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 good morning to you. Yay! Good job, everyone. Let's do that again. So we'll pat those legs again. Good job. Gilly, 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 good morning to you. Gilly, 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 good morning to you. Yay! Good job, everyone. Now we have our five early literacy activities. They are read, write, sing, talk, and play. These are the things we do that get us ready to read, and to help us remember them, we have a song. So can you put one of your hands up and help me sing our song? Good job, Oki. Let's do it. Read, write, sing, talk, play. 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 Yay! Good job. Let's do that again. Hands up one more time. Okay. Read, write, sing, talk, play. 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 Yay! Good job, everyone. Now for today's story, we have a fun one. It's about trees and how leaves change color. And one of the great parts about sharing stories like these is it shows our little ones that language can be used for sharing information. And it's also a really fun way that you can start including factual books. And so that's a great reason. It also opens our kiddos' worldview and teaches them more about the world around them. And for our little ones, that may be as simple as learning shapes. So this is one of my favorite shape books. It's called Shape by Shape, and it's by Suze McDonald. And at the end, there's a dinosaur. I know, super fun. It's a great way to introduce your children to shape. We actually have a whole section of shape books. And if you want help picking out factual picture books, just let me know. That's one of my favorite areas, and I love sharing nonfiction picture books. They're awesome. Okay, everyone, so this is more of a story. So we're going to talk about why leaves change. So a lot of people think that the leaves start changing because the weather changes. You know, we're going through right now with fall and everything. But what's happening, trees actually pay attention to the daylight. And so days are longer in the summer and shorter in the winter. And once those days start getting shorter and the trees are getting less sunlight, they start getting ready for winter. So the green part of trees, that's called chlorophyll. That's in the leaves. And chlorophyll is what the leaves and the tree uses to make food for itself. So when there's less sunlight, the trees stop making food and they kind of hibernate for winter, like a bear. They go to sleep, they become dormant for a little while. And so they pull the chlorophyll from their leaves, and the leaves slowly start changing color. You might see oranges or yellows or browns as fall goes on, as the tree changes, and eventually the entire tree is going to change color. And then do you know what happens? That's right. The leaves start falling off of the tree and it will become bare and ready for winter. Okay, everyone, that's the end. Yay! Good job. Now let's do zoom, zoom, zoom. So for zoom, 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 we're gonna swish those hands together. Good job. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. If you want to take a trip, climb aboard the rocket ship. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. 3, 2, 1, blast off! Good job. Let's do that again. So we'll swish those hands again. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. If you want to take a trip, climb aboard the rocket ship. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. 3, 2, 1, blast off! Good job, everyone. Today I have a ukulele song to share with you. So if you would like, you can dance at home or bop along, whatever we want to do. Are you ready? I'm in the mood for singing. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for singing. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for singing, singing along with you. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that today. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that. Now can you clap your hands? I'm in the mood for clapping. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for clapping. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for clapping. Clapping along with you. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that today. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that. Now can you stomp your feet? I'm in the mood for stomping. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for stomping. Hey, how about you? I'm in the mood for stomping, stomping along with you. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that today. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that. I'm in the mood for that. Good job, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me. If you're looking for a fun activity to do at home, a great way to practice shapes is for kiddos to color them in. And you don't have to have a special coloring book for that. You can just draw shapes on a paper and talk your child through. You know, say this is a triangle, this is a rectangle. You can talk about how many sides it has, how many points there are. It's a really fun way to practice those shapes at home together. And coloring, of course, is a great way for our little ones to practice their writing skills. It's one of the only ways that they can practice their writing skills, even if they've just got a crayon in their grip and they're just going at it like that. That's still a really great way for them to build that foundation for writing later on. Thanks so much for joining me today, everyone. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.